नमस्कार दोस्तों, मेरा नाम धवल, स्वागत है आपका B2B जिम फिटनेस वेलनेस लाइफस्टाइल में। दोस्तों मैं खुद एक जिम ओनर हूं। लॉकडाउन की वजह से सभी जिम्स अभी बंद हैं। हम जिम ओनर के सामने ये बहुत बड़ा प्रश्न चिन्ह है कि अभी सरवाइव कैसे करें, क्योंकि लास्ट लॉकडाउन में बहुत सारे जिम बंद हो चुके हैं, बहुत सारी दिक्कतें थी और अभी ये दूसरा लॉकडाउन शुरू है। फैजल सर के साथ आज जो एपिसोड हम कर रहे हैं वो जिम ओनर्स के लिए और बाकी बिजनेसमैन लोगों के लिए भी एक लाइफ चेंजिंग एपिसोड हो सकता है। उसके लिए जरूरत है ये वीडियो आप अंत तक देखिए और इसमें जो भी सजेशंस केजा सर ने किए हैं उसे समझ के अप्लाई करने का प्रयास कीजिए। सर, डू यू वांट टू से समथिंग अबाउट जिम ओनर्स? डू यू वांट देम टू स्टार्ट समथिंग व्हिच इज ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग?
Yeah, I've actually met a few gym owners and I've given this idea to them, but I think they're in a state of shock right now, most of them. I don't blame them. मेरे को उनके बारे में बहुत बुरा लग रहा है and I think they are the worst hit in the, sorry, in the, they are the worst, एक मिनट हाँ, they are the worst hit in this whole lockdown thing. And you yourself are a gym owner, so you know more than what I'm saying. But this is exactly what happened with gyms. Gym owners got no support from anyone. When the lockdowns were going on, the landlords were not willing to listen, so they got no support from landlords, number one. Then when the unlock happened and after 7 months, they could open doors. After spending on all the COVID measures and everything, after they could open doors, the gyms filled up like this. All the crowd came back.
No.
So there was no, that whole thing that people will now be scared of coming to gyms to work out. They were waiting for the gyms to open. And as soon as the gyms opened, all the crowds came back. I know this again because gym owners was in touch with me. So for that 4 or 5 months that the gyms were open, they were very happy about the business coming back, but that happiness was short-lived. What happened is when the members came back, the members were not willing to understand the gym. Now the member is saying, you give me my 7 months first membership, I will not pay. I've also gone through a loss. So now, earlier, the gym owner had to pay rent on a locked place. Now that the people came back, he had to pay the trainers, he had to pay electricity, and his kharcha increased, and these members are not willing to pay. So my heart goes out to them. I mean, they've been, and worse yet is, I think you told me when you were at my house the last time, that they're all giving out, they're saying, the trainer ko bachao, arre pehle gym owner ko bachao, toh trainer bachayega, number one. And again, when it comes to the fitness industry's position, fitness industry is not dying, Baba. It is thriving. And it is not going to die. And the new gyms will also come. But think about the gym owners that suffered the lockdowns. And how do you blame them? So the point is that it's so sad that people have enjoyed gyms for so long. It's so sad that they've forgotten that they're not supporting the gym owner and the gym owner is getting the brunt from all sides. The trainer is cursing them, sala tumne pagar nahi diya. The members are saying, humko malum nahi, hamara pehla 7 mahine ka do. The landlord is not willing to listen. Chai, like, yeah, I mean, what? My
banks are not ready to listen.
Sorry?
Banks are not ready to listen.
Banks are not ready to give moratoriums. Moratorium deta hai, toh interest chadata hai. It's just madness. And it is a failure on part of the legal system, the law, the people who don't understand that businesses are the reason why there is employment and businesses are the reason. Support business, you're supporting the employees also. If you don't support business, you're the one who's not supporting the employees, not the businessman. He can't do without the employees. He wants the employees. He wants to pay, but then how are you making him able to pay? My advice was to gym owners who could survive this. There were some who could survive. my advice to them was, now become a complete hybrid. You will now be a gym that has got three ways in which you interact with customers. Three ways. One is, of course, your family. People will still want to come to the gym. So, jab lockdown khulenge tab, people will still want to come to the gym. There are just some people who cannot train at home. So, they will be there. There will be the paranoid kinds who will say, मेरे को घर पे ही मेरे को जिम पे नहीं आने का है वर्कआउट करने के लिए, आई एम स्केर्ड, आई एम स्टिल स्केर्ड, कैन यू सेंड अ ट्रेनर होम. नाउ द पॉइंट इज दैट दिस इज समथिंग आई हैव लर्नड फ्रॉम फ्रॉम स्टीव जॉब्स, एंड स्टीव जॉब्स टॉट दिस टू ऑल द अदर बिजनेसेस आल्सो. व्हेन यू हैव अ प्रोडक्ट, ओके, व्हेन यू हैव अ प्रोडक्ट, देयर विल ऑलवेज बी समबडी हु विल इनोवेट अ बेटर आइडिया एंड किल योर प्रोडक्ट. What Steve Jobs used to do is, before somebody thought of a better idea, he would only think of a better idea and kill his product. He never wanted to stick around with one product. Abhi ho gaya, ho gaya, ho gaya. Chalo abhi naya aur ye abhi band karo. The iPod was so revolutionary. It was so revolutionary. The iPod. Pura ghar ka wo series pura nikal gaya. पॉकेट में 1000 सॉन्ग्स इन अ पॉकेट, दैट वाज हिज थिंग. हाउ वुड यू लाइक टू हैव 1000 सॉन्ग्स इन योर पॉकेट, एंड दैट क्लिक दैट डायल क्लिक डायल थिंग एंड ऑल दैट. द आईपॉड वाज फैंटास्टिक, पीपल वर वेयरिंग इट ऑन देयर आर्म व्हाइल जॉगिंग, यू नो ना, इट वाज एवरीवेयर. व्हाट ही डिड वाज द आईफोन, देन ही सेड क्यों दो दो क्यों मांगता है. द iPod का पूरा powers he put inside the phone and he killed the iPod. अभी भी iPod बेचते हैं ये, but iPod बचाने के लिए normally what other companies do is iPod ये product बचाने के लिए ये हम release नहीं करते हैं, नहीं तो ये मर जाएगा. And he used to be a serial killer of his own innovations by innovating further. And one more shocking thing I'll tell you, which I learned. These are all my business lessons, which I learned from my reading. That at one point in time, the richest company in the world was Kodak. Okay? And why was Kodak? What did Kodak? It's a camera photograph company. What did Kodak do which was so revolutionary? Memories. Memories are something that are integral to humans. We want memories. And when photography started, during Queen Elizabeth's time, earlier, when she was young, when she had just become King George's time, during that time, photography was there. Okay? Magar agar tumko ek family ka photograph lene ka hai na, to pura din jata tha. Alright? Pahla to pura ban thang ke hum log ready rehta tha. फिर एक वैन में फोटोग्राफर आता था विद इक्विपमेंट पूरा भरा हुआ फोटो ये, और 10 जन उसका क्रू का वो कैमरा वाला, और सब लोग को पोज मार के ऐसा खड़ा करने का, तब वो फैमिली का फोटो बनता था. वो राजा महाराजा लोग का जो रहता था ना फोटोज, यू हैड टू कॉल अ प्रोफेशनल. सो देयर वाज नो सच थिंग एज अ कैंडिड मेमोरी, जैसे कि अभी कैंडिड मेमोरीज रहते ना, देयर वाज नो सच थिंग के अरे क्लिक. वाइल्ड लाइफ फोटोग्राफी जैसा तो मतलब कि कैसा करेगा, यू कांट प्लान. सो दिस एम एंड शूट कैमरा वाज क्रिएटेड बाय कोडाक, वेयर वन एंटायर प्रोफेशन डाइड, द प्रोफेशन ऑफ द photographer. Now everybody had the power to take photographs,
right,
at their functions, on their holidays, honeymoon. So he just, now Kodak used to sell two things, okay, the camera and also the film. Okay, Kodak kept on improving on the product, kept on doing that. Pehla aisa sare mind tha, बाद में ऑटो खड़ा करके अपने आप घूमता है, क्या क्या नहीं किया हम लोग. देयर वाज अ गाय इन कोडाक हु सेड कि लिसन, आई नो ऑफ अ वे ऑफ मेकिंग अ कैमरा वेयर दीज रोल्स विल नॉट बी रिक्वायर्ड डिजिटल. कोडाक के कंपनी में था और कोडाक तभी सॉलिड सरप्लस कैश में था, सॉलिड सरप्लस कैश. कोडाक वॉज द कंपनी दैट सेड प्रोफेशनल्स को निकालो एंड गिव द पावर टू द मासेस ऑफ क्लिकिंग फोटोग्राफ्स. एंड देयर वॉज अ मैन इन कोडाक हु सेड, जो डिजिटल फोटोग्राफी अभी करते हैं हम लोग विदाउट फिल्म, आई नो हाउ टू मेक वन एंड ही डिड गिव अ प्रोटोटाइप. Do you know what Kodak did? Kodak cancelled the prototype for one reason. They said that acha idea hai, magar this will kill our roll market. Roll ka market, not the product. Camera product market nahi. But hum log kya kar rahe hain? Har aadmi jo camera leta hai, usko wapas roll khareedna padta hai. So they are not thinking about the customer, they're thinking about themselves. Right. And they were at the cusp of industry where if you did not think about customer, you would fail. So they had the technology. They said, "Arey, fir hamara role kon rega? Itna stock para hua hai." And then Fuji, a Japanese company, came up with digital, and they killed Kodak. That company was invincible. So this is a very scary thing when you don't do things because you feel agar hum log ne hi trainer ko ghar pe bheja to hamare gym pe kon aayega.
Right.
Now why do you want the business to go to a personal training agency?
Very true.
Why do you want the business to go to an app? Why don't you only start? Like, it's not a new idea. First of all, it is not a new idea because a restaurant that does home delivery doesn't think ki agar main home delivery karega to yahan pe kam log aayega. Correct or no?
Baro.
So today if a restaurant doesn't tie up with Swiggy, he'll die. The gym should be like that, home delivery also and at the gym also.
Yes.
Now there is a third category. The third category is that itna paranoid aadmi hai, ya shayad wo aadmi paranoid nahi hai magar uska society ka secretary sala haram kor allow nahi karta andar logon ko bahar ke logon ko aane ke liye. Right. So agar aisa hai, then boss, don't worry. So supposing it is B2B. So your salesperson will say B2B has three modes that we can offer you. You can see our gym. It's wonderful. You can come to our gym and work out. And our personal trainers, as you may have heard, are the best. And you'll get the best of service. So you can do that. In case you have a home gym set up or you want to train at home, we can send a B2B personal trainer to your house also. We've got that service also. That's a different charge, of course. And in case you want to train at home and during lockdown you can't come, now who knows, now next time, another 2 months, there might be another lockdown, who knows. If you cannot come, or let's say that you have already come here, so you want to join the gym, I understand that. But maybe your wife or your brother or whoever doesn't really want to come to the gym and is also paranoid about some personal trainer coming to his house. We also have the third mode, which is remote personal training. As you can see, those workstations out there, and in my mind's eye, what I'm visualizing is like how a call center is. So a better way of a call center, think of big, wide, muscular backs, B2B trainer, right, written over there, or remote personal trainer, aisa kuch to bhi t-shirt pe likha hua hai. They are all like this. So you will be seeing 10 of them. In front of them, there is a TV screen, correct? And they are seeing their client training there. They've got earphones with a mouthpiece, right? Noise cancellation. And they are busy So 10 personal trainers of B2B are handling 10 clients in one go at their homes.
Fantastic.
So my idea of the gym of tomorrow, if ever I set up a gym, I want to provide personal training and general training services on the gym floor. I want to have a separate section called as remote personal training, and I want all the personal trainers in that line of remote personal training stations. Right. Where they all are looking and all are counting reps and pushing the customer and training them. A B2B personal trainer is also going house to house.
Super.
Don't allow any of the other businesses to overtake you. Personal trainer at home, we do it. Remote personal training, we only do it. Commercial gym, yes, we have it. Yeah. The point is all three. These are mine. But nothing like phone pay consultation, yeah, diet email, yeah, workout plan, yeah, not that. Just this. So how do you like this new gym setup?
This is fantastic, sir.
And the problem here will be just the human brain. They will start thinking about problems only. And believe me, all of these things have problems in them. And what you have to do is you have to understand that the idea is good. Jump in, tackle one problem as they come. Keep bettering the products.
Right. This is super.
Yeah, this is my advice to the gym owners. And yes, then now there will be somebody, arre sir, paisa kidhar hai? So, bhai, agar paisa nahi hai, toh main tere liye nahi bol raha hoon. Magar jiske paas hai, wo toh kare.
Right.
Ya wo bhi dube.
This will help us to retain our existing members also, sir.
And it will help you to pull out anybody who is trying to take your customers away.
Absolutely. This is fantastic.
And there are personality types. So we don't reduce our customers. There are kinds of people who cannot train at home, hate to train at home. They'll come to your gym.
Yeah.
There are people who will never come to your gym. You're reaching them also.
True.
And there are people who even after COVID-19, everything, for the rest of their lives, they will be worried about liquid droplets from people. Remote person.
Super.
So, this is my entire, I never spoke like this before. It was through sheer reading and understanding that business is not that complicated. It's about thinking from the customer standpoint. Always, what is best for the customer? And when you say from the customer standpoint, never ever make the mistake of asking the customer, tumko kya chahiye? Tumko weird answers milenge. Oh, wrong hai. You are in a better position to think what is best for your customer, not your customer.
Very good.
There was one Steve Jobs interview, I remember, and that same thing happened. Somebody asked him, but don't you want to know what customers want? And at that time, Steve Jobs, in a very characteristic way, why do you think they pay me? They pay me to think for them. I am supposed to think for them. I will think for them. They are not able to.
Which is true.
Yes. I don't need to ask them. I need to think on their behalf.
Right.
What would enrich their life? And that doesn't mean you don't listen to customer complaints. People think that. So that is different. If a customer says, "Wow, I don't like your product," listen. Why he doesn't like it? But before making a product, don't ask, "Tumko kya pasand hai?" Wo kuch. उसको कैसा मालूम रहे बाबा ही इज नॉट अ विजनरी एवरी इफ एवरीबॉडी वाज अ विजनरी द वर्ल्ड वुड बी डिफरेंट ऑफ मी एंटायरली सो व्हाट स्टीव जॉब्स इज टीचिंग अस इज दैट वी आर डोमेन एक्सपर्ट्स एंड अ डोमेन एक्सपर्ट नीड्स टू डू व्हाट क्रिएट प्रोडक्ट्स दैट अ कस्टमर कैन नॉट थिंक ऑफ एंड make the product from the point of view of the customer but since you are a visionary you will think about the customer better than the customer will think about himself so main ye kehna cha raha hu ki ek dar rehta hai ki jo trainers logon ke gharon pe jate hain wo log khud ba khud gym ko kaat lenge wo direct kar lenge with the client ye hota hai hua hai mere sath bhi hua hai bahut pehle ab ऑलवेज जैसे मैंने कहा कस्टमर के एंगल से देखो क्या उनको ज्यादा फायदा है ट्रेनर के साथ डायरेक्ट करने के लिए एक्चुअली नहीं इनफैक्ट उनका डिसएडवांटेज है ये करके क्योंकि अगर वो जिम के साथ ही रहते हैं तो ये ट्रेनर इज अकाउंटेबल और ये ट्रेनर ने कुछ मिसबिहेव किया या ट्रेनर लेट आते रहता है या बीच में बोलता है अरे मैं नहीं आ पाऊंगा देयर आर लॉट ऑफ मिसटर्न्स किधर तो भी कंप्लेन करने के लिए हमेशा अच्छा रहता है कोई क्लाइंट को कि भाई मैं फोन कर सकता हूँ मुझे ये क्या है करके और दूसरी बात कि अगर एजेंसी है कोई नई एजेंसी खुला है ओनली सेंडिंग होम पर्सनल ट्रेनर्स एंड आई हैव बीन पार्ट ऑफ अ जिम मेंबर आई हैव बीन पार्ट ऑफ अ जिम फॉर द लॉन्गेस्ट टाइम इफ आई हैव अ चॉइस बिटवीन दिस जिम सेंडिंग मी ए ट्रेनर एंड सम एजेंसी दैट आई हैव नेवर सीन I don't know where their office is also.
True.
So I'm equating that. उदाहरण के तौर पे हम लोग सब लोग स्विगी से ऑर्डर करते हैं हम लोग सब लोग ये एंड ऐसे भी हैं जो सेंट्रल किचन हैं जो रेस्टोरेंट नहीं है वहां पे कोई बैठता नहीं है वहां पे कोई गया नहीं है इट इज अ सेंट्रल किचन वहां से पूरा डिस्ट्रीब्यूट होता है खाना और बड़े बड़े नाम रेस्टोरेंट में जैसे कि मैं अभी घर पे अगर मेरे को खाना खाना है मैं कोई सेंट्रल स्विगी से मैं कोई सेंट्रल किचन का ऑर्डर दे सकता हूँ नहीं तो डायरेक्टली गजाली को फोन करके गजाली से मैं मंगा सकता हूँ अब गजाली एक बहुत रेप्यूटेड होटल है वहाँ पे हम बहुत बार गए हैं वहाँ का खाना क्या है हमको मालूम है वो क्वालिटी क्या है मालूम है मैं वो होटल से मंगाएगा नॉट फ्रॉम अ सेंट्रल किचन So gyms actually have an advantage over personal training agencies. They have an advantage. They are there. People know where they are. अगर कुछ हो गया तो जाके उन लोग कुछ बात कर सकते हैं reception पे क्या ऐसा ऐसा हो गया है क्या है. This idea has to be sold to the member that you are safer with us. Number one. Number two. Once the services get delivered to a person's house, what we have done in the past is very stupid. एक बार हमारा ट्रेनर जाता है ना हम वापस कॉल करते ही नहीं हमारा कनेक्ट रहता ही नहीं है अब वो क्लाइंट के लिए करता धरता सब कुछ है वो पर्सनल ट्रेनर और हमको अगर वो अवॉइड करना है हमको क्या करना है आफ्टर एवरी सेशन देयर शुड बी अ फीडबैक कॉल हाउ वाज इट सर ओके ही हैड कम विद ऑल द सैनिटाइजर एवरीथिंग डिड ही मेंटेन ऑल द प्रोटोकॉल्स How was your training session today? Good. नहीं तो ट्रेनर को पूछने का कभी क्या रहे आज क्या किया How was, कौन सा वर्कआउट दिया उसको बोलेगा सर लेग वर्कआउट दिया कुछ हुआ क्या ज्यादा बढ़ा क्या उसका स्क्वाट हाँ सर आज पी आर किया वंस यू हैव दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन कॉल अप आई दिस इज धवल फ्रॉम बी टू बी या आई हर्ड यू हैड अ ग्रेट सेशन टूडे आई हर्ड द ट्रेनर वॉज कॉम्प्लीमेंटिंग यू यू डिड अ पी आर टूडे इन द स्क्वाट्स अरे बाप रे ओ तो That belonging can be created if you are constantly in touch and constantly asking. Hope everything all right. You know you can call me if something goes wrong. You know you can call me. The client never forgets you. Problem with personal training at home is we first talk to the client. We say yes, we can send you. Then the trainer keeps going, correct? And once the trainer keeps going, we stop calling. Right. And we are in touch only with the trainer. क्या रे renew कर रहा है ना? अगला 12 टर्न हाँ अच्छा रिन्यू कर रहे हम क्लाइंट के साथ बात ही नहीं कर रहे और फिर क्या होता है वो ट्रेनर बोलेगा नहीं अभी उन लोग इंटरेस्टेड नहीं है ये नहीं वो नहीं है एंड एक्चुअली उसके साथ कंटिन्यू करेगा
Right.
Why should I listen to my trainer whether he's interested or not? Why not I call for the renewal? Every agency that has said, "Arey, it doesn't work, yaar, they bloody take away the clients and they are doing it on their own," have been the people who have only interacted with the customer the first time, and once the trainer went there, they just... The customer needs to know the trainer who comes here, there, to them less, and needs to know the agency more.
Right. Through nutrition also, we can be connected with them, sir.
Of course. For any service that is provided. Even the remote personal trainer's customers.
Right.
That way what happens is, if a trainer also decides to leave, or you decide because of some misconduct, woh ghar baithe baithe unko train nahi kar sakta hai.
Right. So basically, it is a team which is training them. It is not an individual who is training them.
Correct. Another thing is, when one trainer leaves, you better see to it that when somebody else trains the person, that person is A-grade. So when one trainer leaves, ensure that the replacement just blows that trainer out of the memory of
that member.
And don't force the member to be with you. Say that, I know that he used to train you well and all that. That is what all our trainers do. Just give me one more chance. I'm not saying that you have to train with the trainer that we sent. It's finally a monthly package, no? So don't worry about it. But say no after I send you the trainer. Not before. And then select your absolute star. और उसको बोल के रखने का, देख भाई तो एक बार उधर गया ना, वो दूसरा ट्रेनर भूल जाना चाहिए वो. एंड देन इफ दैट अदर ट्रेनर हु लेफ्ट यू इज सो पावरफुल दैट नहीं दे वांट हिम ओनली, डोंट फाइट इट. से ऑलराइट, इफ आई एम नॉट बी एबल टू मेजर अप टू दैट ट्रेनर, फाइन. बिकॉज इफ ही इज ट्रूली बीन अनप्रोफेशनल विद यू, ही विल बिकम अनप्रोफेशनल विद देम एंड दे विल कॉल यू बैक.
Right.
It's this fighting with the customer nahi chalta hai. No, you cannot, and no, you have to, no, I don't need to give you a refund. Kya? They liked your service when that trainer was there, that trainer's left. They don't like the next trainer you sent. And it's a customer, yeah, didn't like. How can you force it?
Very true. Kaisa sir, thank you very much for joining us today. And I am 100% sure that it is going to change many gym owners and trainers' perspective towards looking at their business.
Let's hope so.
And those who are sincerely trying to survive in the industry, they are getting a very good direction. Thank you very much, sir. Thanks a lot.
I'd like to say one last thing.
Yes, sir.
That all the advice that I've given to gym owners is practical advice that should be used, and I have given this with one intention in mind, that my business depends on the fitness industry thriving. So people in the fitness industry should take my advice seriously, because I am giving this advice not in a selfless way. I want gyms to thrive. I want job opportunities to increase, because then my students get great jobs, and hence my advice should be taken seriously, because it is meant to be applied. It is not only for a Instagram live or whatever. It's if they apply it, and if it does well, I know my business will also do much, much better.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.